Translating Keywords into Math Expressions by Alison Hammack. Okay, so I've made a chart here. These are key phrases that we see in word problems that we need to be able to change into mathematical statements. So first, looking at addition, keywords or phrases, we have our plus, more than, the sum of, the total of, increased by, added to. So let's look at examples for this. Plus, a number plus 4. A number plus 4, the way we would translate that, if that's in a word problem, is we would have x plus 4. More than, 6 more than a number. In this case, the x will come first, and then the 6 will come. 6 more than a number, the number part first, this is the x part, this is going to come first, and then the 6 comes after. Next we have the sum of a number and 2. The sum of a number, let's call that x, and 2, will look like this. The total of 6 and a number is going to have 6 and a number. A number increased by 3. A number increased by 3, this is like adding 3 to the number. So we start with our number, which is our x, and we add 3. 10 added to a number. 10 added to a number, so we start with a number, and then we're going to add 10. So the tricky ones in this list, more than tends to be one of the tricky, because it comes in reverse order. The 6 came first in the word problem, and yet the x will come first when we translate it. Okay, now let's look at subtraction. Subtraction keywords or phrases are minus, less than, the difference of, less, decreased by, or subtracted from. These are the words you'll see for subtraction. So let's do an example here. If we have a number minus 2, we're going to write this as x minus 2. Let's try less than. If we have 3 less than a number, we are going to have x minus 3. So even though the 3 comes first here, when we translate it, the 3 has to come second because we have to have this number piece, this x piece first. The difference of a number and 3, the difference, I'm going to abbreviate it here, of 10 and 3. So this one here, we have numbers in here. The difference of 10 and 3, we're going to write it like this, 10 minus 3. Of course, we could do that math then, too. Okay, the next one is less. If we have 8 less a number, we would have something like this, where we would have 8 minus x. Okay? Decreased by. If we have a number decreased by 2, we're going to write this as x minus 2. And then lastly, subtracted from. If we have 5 subtracted from a number, we are going to get x minus 5. Okay, now we're on multiplication. Multiplication is the x symbol here, or a dot. Words for multiplication in a word problem are times, the product of, twice or double, multiplied by, and the word of. When you see these in a word problem, they're going to mean multiplication. 4 times a number is going to look like this, which is 4x. The product of 2 and 3 is going to be 2 times 3. Of course, we could do that math, that would be 6. Twice a number is going to be 2x. Multiplied by, we have a number multiplied by negative 1, we're going to have negative 1x, like this, okay? And the word of, this occurs a lot in a lot of word problems. So for this example, we would have 1/2 of a number. 1/2 of a number is going to be translated as 1/2x, where it's implied that it's multiplication between those two. Okay, next we have division. The symbol is this. Words that represent division in a word problem are the quotient of, divided by, and the ratio of. Starting with the quotient of, if we had a sentence that said the quotient of 4 and 5, we would translate this or write this as 4 divided by 5, like this. Okay, division divided by, if we had a sentence that said 10 divided by a number, we are going to have the 10 in the numerator and the x in the denominator. And then the ratio of a number to 5 is going to look like this. That's going to be an x over 5. Okay, next we have powers. And powers in a word problem are going to be referred to as the square of, or something squared, or the cube of, or cubed. So let's use the phrase, the square of a number. That's going to look like this. It's going to have the x and then a little superscript of a 2. Okay, the cube of a number is going to have your x and a subscript, superscript of a 3. Lastly, it's very common to have the word equals in a word problem. These are ways that it is represented. They could actually say the word equals. They could say is the same as, yields, or amounts to. So for equals, if we have 6 less than a number equals 2, squeeze it in here, it would be translated like this. It would be x minus 6 equals 2, because remember, less than is one of those that is switched, okay? Less than is one of those trickier ones. Let's underline it up here. Less than is one of the trickier. Okay, is. If we have a statement that says 2 times a number is 4, we would translate that 2 times a number equals 4. Is the same as, let's do this one here next. 3 is the same as x. 3 is the same as x means 3 equals x. Yields. 2 added to 4 yields 6. So 2 added to 4 yields 6. And then lastly, amounts to 6 less a number amounts to 10. So we want to translate this. We're putting both of these together and we'll label it here. So 6 less a number amounts to 10 is going to be 6 minus a number equals 10.